Today we're going to talk about 7.1, which is rational functions and simplifying rational expressions. The beginning of this section is about domain, which we have discussed before. You've had on the test for chapter 3. In chapter 3, we used interval notation. The difference in this section is they're going to ask for set builder notation. So when we talk about set builder notation, we will always start with, it's a set, so we put our braces, we put our variable, whatever our variable is for the problem, and then we say x is a real number, which those are our abbreviations, and any restrictions. So this goes back to the idea before where we had restrictions. Remember our rules for domain and range that we've talked about before. So this is a review. We assume our answer, all real numbers for the answer. And then we look for restrictions. The first restrictions is that the denominator cannot equal zero. And remember, restrictions are something that makes it undefined or not a real answer, because we're looking for a real answer as a y value coming out of the problem. And so the other one we've talked about is a radical, which we will get into on test 5. Underneath a radical has to be positive, remember, to get a real answer. So whatever's underneath there has got to be greater than or equal to zero. So that's a refresher. Not new. You've been tested on this before. So on all of these problems here, we're going to start off assuming my answer is all real numbers. And if the answer is all real numbers, we just take off this restriction part in the list. So these all are going to deal with rational functions. So we're going to be looking at the denominator restrictions. So on this first one, we are going to take the denominator, and x minus 5 cannot equal 0. So x cannot equal 5. So that's my restriction I'm plugging into that highlighted box in the top. So my variable for this problem is x. X can be a real number, and x cannot equal 5 is my restriction. That's my answer for number 1. So looking at number 2, we're looking again at the denominator. So q squared minus 3q plus 2 cannot equal 0. We're going to factor it. This is the same thing that you just did from 6.6. So my factors should be q minus 2, q minus 1 cannot equal 0. So if I solve the first one, q can't equal 2, and the second one, q cannot equal 1. So my answer for number 2, start with your variable, so notice the q this time. Q can be a real number, and list your restrictions, q cannot equal 1 or 2. So I want you to again start pausing these and start doing them yourself and see that if you can get them correct or not. So on number 3, we take the denominator. 4a minus 7 cannot equal 0. So 4a cannot equal 7. A cannot equal 7/4. So my answer for this problem, a is my variable. A is a real number. And A cannot equal 7/4. So we've now done 1, 2, and 3 for this problem. So again, I want you to pause it and try to do 4, 5, and 6 and come back and see if you get the right answers. So going to number 4, set my denominator equal to 0. There's nothing to solve. So that is actually my restrictions. I go to M. M can be a real number. And M cannot equal 0. That's it. A lot of times we try to make these more challenging. What I see happens on the test is y'all try to start solving the numerators as well. Remember what the definition of a domain is. Domain is what values of x can I plug in to get a real answer out. So I'm looking for all real numbers that work. And so essentially you're just saying what doesn't work, let me take that out of it. So going to number 5. Again, remember you're only concerned with what's in the denominator. 5 can never equal 0. There are no restrictions for number 5. So for number 5, my answer is, my variable is t, so t is a real number. That's it. Okay. Don't again overanalyze it. You're looking for this problem and you're saying what works or doesn't work. Going to number 6, we have x squared plus 1 in the denominator. So I'm going to take this part. So x squared plus 1 cannot equal 0. In this case, can you factor this? Be careful, your answer should be no. It's not a difference of squares. So this problem actually would give us complex numbers as an answer, which we're not looking at for our domain. Domain is only asking for real answers. So my answer for this problem as well, x such that x is a real number. There are no restrictions for this problem. So remember that back in chapter 3, you had the same rules for domain. Same thing for chapter 7. Same thing will be for the next test as well. You will definitely see this on the test, definitely on the quiz. Make sure you're comfortable with it.